My name is Elizabeth Hillman, and my research involves developing new imaging methods, microscopy methods, and optical techniques using lasers and light to image the living brain and to understand the way that the brain functions and the way that the brain regulates its blood flow. We took very high-speed camera images of the blood vessels on the surface of the brain. And when we did a stimulus, we were able to actually watch the blood vessels dilate at really, really high speeds. And when we did that, we saw this sort of spreading of the dilation of those vessels. And that's something that people hadn't really seen before because no one had imaged as fast as we'd managed to image. But what we found is basically that there's this layer of cells on the inside of blood vessels called the endothelium, which nobody had really looked at in great detail in the brain before, but we found that it's capable of actually sending signals, propagating signals, and that this propagation of signals is a really important component of increasing blood flow in the brain. So this gives us new insight into how this blood flow regulation is working at a sort of mechanistic level. It's also really important because nobody thought that this process was taking place in the brain, even though it's known to take place everywhere else in the body. And this provides a new link to other diseases in the rest of the body that we know affect these endothelial cells, but nobody's really thought about the possibility that they tie into the brain. The reason why so many people are interested in this blood flow response is because it's the basis of the signal that you measure in functional MRI. And so functional MRI is this technique that you can use to image the brains of humans and will give you these beautiful maps where you see this big bright red blob that says, right, this is where the activation is happening. Well, that MRI machine is actually measuring a change in the amount of deoxyhemoglobin in the brain. So it actually measures a change in the blood, not in the neurons. And people have been struggling for years to understand, well, what does it mean when that region is bigger or smaller or faster or slower? And we haven't had any way to really understand what that means in terms of the neurons. And so our new finding can allow us to explain better why the blood flow responses look the way that they do. Just from the sake of brain health, it has to be important that the brain regulates its blood flow properly. You know, if it doesn't do that, even in the short term, you might not be able to respond as quickly, you might not be able to think straight effectively, right? When you're really hungry, you can't think straight, right? But longer term, if your neurons aren't getting what they need every time they need it, you're going to start to get neurodegeneration. And you know, we have a population of elderly people who are getting dementia and Alzheimer's and a lot of diseases, which now people are realizing more and more might involve the vasculature. And I think it's just an oversight not to look at it and think of it as a really important part of the way the brain works. So really, the main theme of my work right now is that blood flow regulation in the brain is really important for brain health, and it might be more common than we think that this regulation gets damaged in some way. So we think this is a way to better understand the sort of neural consequences of systemic diseases, things like cardiovascular disease and diabetes, and maybe points to new ways in which those disorders could be treated. So I'm very excited to be involved with the new Zuckerman Institute for Mind Brain. It's going to be a fabulous environment that brings together really multidisciplinary investigators. I'm excited to bring my optical imaging tools because I think that they're going to be really valuable in all different areas of neuroscience, and it's going to be great to be able to, you know, set them up and invite people in and help them to develop them for all sorts of different purposes.